Note, the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the top cover. Removal. Carefully disconnect the wireless antenna cables from the wireless module by grasping the connectors with a small pair of needle-nose pliers or tweezers. Caution! Use care when disconnecting the wireless antenna cables from the wireless module. A damaged cable or connector can degrade notebook performance. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchscreen ZIF connector and disconnect the touchscreen cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the USB board ZIF connector and disconnect the USB board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Disconnect the speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the display panel ZIF connector and disconnect the display panel cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Disconnect the power connector cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the hard disk drive ZIF connector and disconnect the hard disk drive ribbon cable from the system board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the 2mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the wireless module to the base enclosure. Remove the 5 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Remove the touchscreen and wireless antenna cables from the routing channel on the base enclosure and fan. Carefully lift the system board off of the alignment pins on the base enclosure and remove. Replacement. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board. Fan heatsink assembly, real-time clock battery, memory modules and shield, wireless module. Place the system board onto the alignment pins on the base enclosure. Caution! To avoid damage, ensure that all cables are free from being pinched between the system board and base enclosure. Route the wireless antenna and touchscreen cables through the routing channel on the fan and base enclosure. Replace the 5 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Replace the 2mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the wireless module to the base enclosure. Insert the hard disk drive ribbon cable into the hard disk drive ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Connect the power connector cable into its connector on the system board. Insert the display panel cable into the display panel ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Connect the speaker cable into its connector on the system board. Insert the USB board ribbing cable into the USB board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbing cable. Insert the touchscreen cable into the touchscreen ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and cable. Reconnect the wireless antenna cables to the wireless module. Caution: use care when connecting the wireless antenna cables to the wireless module. A damaged cable or connector can degrade notebook performance. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.